we will now discuss a question related to the number of finite abelian groups up to isomorphism from the section group theory. And this type of questions are relevant and will be helpful for all those aspirants of junior lecturer, degree lecturer, TS set and AP set. Now, before getting into the discussion, let's now learn some preliminary concepts. The first concept is the partition of a positive integer. Let n be a positive integer. How do we define the partition of n? It is defined as a partition of n is any non-decreasing sequence of positive integers whose sum is n. Let's say n1 less than or equal to n2 less than or equal to etc. less than or equal to nk, where non-decreasing sequence of positive integers ni such that n1 plus n2 plus etc. plus nk is n, then n1, n2, etc. nk is called a partition of n. So, a partition of n is any non-decreasing sequence of positive integers whose sum is n. For example, if you take 7, seven can be written as 1, 1, 1, 1, 7 times. That's one partition. You can also write 5 ones, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 5 ones and 2. So that's also a partition. So like that, 1, 1, 2, 3 is also a partition. Why? This is a non-decreasing sequence of positive integers, 1 less than or equal to 1, less than or equal to 2, less than or equal to 3. And the sum is 7. So it is 7. So we have seen the 7 has more than one partition. Now the question is, how many partitions are there for a given n? That's the question. And that means we first talk about the number of partitions. The number of partitions is given, is denoted by P of n. So the number of partitions of n is denoted by P of n. So P of 7, that means how many partitions will be there for 7? That's the question. So let's go one by one and we study P of n for small values of n. Suppose you take 1, 1 can be written as 1 only. So that means there is only one partition. For example, you take 2, it can be written as 1 plus 1 and 2. That means there are two partitions for that. And if you take 3, it can be written as 1 plus 1 plus 1 three times and 1 plus 2 and 3. That means there are three partitions for that. And if you take n is equal to 4, it has 5 partitions. How? 1 plus 1 plus 1 four times, 1 plus 1 plus 2, 2 plus 2, 1 plus 3, 4. These are the 5 partitions. So you have to remember these values. P of 5 is 7. How? You do it for yourself. P of 6 is 11. Do it for yourself. Remembering these values is an advantage, etc. Now, we recall a theorem that we have studied in our MSc class. That is, the theorem is the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order p power n, where p is a prime number and n is a positive integer, is given by p of n. P of n is the number of partitions of n. So if you want to 2 square, how many? 2 cube, how many? 3 square, how many? 3 cube, how many? 11 to the power 4, how many? You can talk about that ones. The number of non-isomorphic abelian groups, you can talk about it. So you take, for example, let alpha and beta be the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 16 and 81 respectively. Then, so that means, what is alpha? Number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 16. How 16 can be written as 2 power 4. So how many, the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 2 power 4 occurred by the above theorem is P of 4. So alpha is P of 4. And this 81 you take, 81 is also 3 power 4. So the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 3 power 4 is P of 4 only. It doesn't depend upon, so it depends on the exponent. So beta is also P of 4. So alpha is equal to beta is equal to P of 4. So options, we are given options. Option A, alpha is equal to 4, beta is equal to 5. Option B, alpha is equal to 5, beta is equal to 4. Now, option C, alpha is equal to beta is equal to 4. Option D, this is not C, this is D. Alpha is equal to beta is equal to 5. So the answer is option D. That is, now 16 is 2 power 4, 81 is 3 power 4, alpha is P of 4, beta is P of 4, and P of 4 is 5. Therefore, alpha is equal to beta is equal to 5. This is the D. This is the D, D is the option. So you can say this is your D. You can rectify it. So you say this is D. This is D. Anyway, so now let's get into the next one. So example, the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 32. So how many? 32 is 2 power. So we are given options. Option A, 2. Option B, 3. Option C, 5. Option D, 7. 32 is written as 2 power 5. So the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 2 power 5 is P of 5. P of 5 is 7. How? So here is your P of 5, partitions of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So P of 5 is 7. Agreed. So that is the result. Next we go to a very important theorem, which depends upon the fundamental theorem of finite abelian groups. So the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order n, whose prime factorization is p1 to the power of alpha 1 into p2 to the power of alpha 2, etc., into pk to the power of alpha k, where pi, that means p1, p2, pk are distinct primes, alpha I are positive integers, is given by p of alpha 1 multiplied by p of alpha 2 multiplied by p of alpha k, where p of alpha I denotes the number of partitions of alpha I. And this actually follows from a well-known theorem, fundamental theorem of finite abelian groups. And I suggest that all these aspirants must go through this fundamental theorem of finite abelian groups and its implications. Agreed. So this is a very important result. And now we apply this for some of the questions here. So here is a question that has come in TS set 2023 mathematics. And this is question number 68 with his question ID. And the question is, up to isomorphism, The number of abelian groups of order 56 is, options are given. Option 1, 1. Option 2, 2. Option 3, 3. Option 4, 4. So now how? Now it is 56. N is equal to 56 means it's not a power of a prime. So write the prime factorization. So take that. So order of G is 56. And order of G is written, 56 is written as 2 cube into 7 to the power of 1. Now apply the above result. If you apply the above result, the number of abelian groups up to isomorphism will be P of 3 multiplied by P of 1, where P of n is the number of partitions of n. P of 3, you know that it is 3, and P of 1 is 1. You have to remember. So this is 3 into 1, that is 3. So look at the, so the our answer is option 3, that is the up to isomorphism there are 3 abelian groups of order 56. That's your question, that is answer. And here is a homework for you. The homework is the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of order 1800 is. You have to do this one. And I say that you write your answer in the comments box. So that is the discussion of the concepts of the partition of a positive integer and the number of partitions of a given positive integers and the related theorems for the number of non-isomorphic abelian groups of or groups of a given order. I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem and solution of these problems and concepts that I have explained to you. And I wish you all the best. Thank you.